Ideally, scientists would love to be able to conduct research with an entire population of subjects. Thus, typically, the population is the group of scientific interest, but because it is usually not logistically possible to conduct an experiment with and give a treatment to everyone in the population, scientists actually study a sample and then generalize the results obtained on the sample to the population. In short, the population is the group to which results from the sample will be generalized. To the degree that the characteristics of the sample reflect the variety of characteristics of the people in the population, we can be more confident that the results from our work with the sample can be generalized to the population. So as this course progresses, we will be talking about two, what I like to call, parallel universes, one being the universe of the population and one being the universe of the sample. We will learn terms, notations, symbols, and procedures that are unique and applicable to the population, and terms, notations, symbols, and procedures that are unique and applicable to the sample. Some terms we use can be applied equally to a population or sample, but when it is important to distinguish the measurements or scores we collect from a population from those we collect from a sample, we use specific terms designed to communicate where those scores came from. So the measurements or scores we collect from a population we refer to as population parameters. And the measurements or scores we collect from sample we refer to as sample statistics. When you start working with problems, it will be important to read the problems carefully to spot important terms like these. That will get you oriented properly to proceed in the correct way and apply the correct procedures that are chosen for the analysis of the population parameters versus the analysis of sample statistics. An important concept for you to understand now that will be applied throughout all the chapters in this book is the concept of sampling error. The drawing on this slide is a demonstration of sampling error. In the circle are population parameters or data that have been collected on a population of 1,000 college students. The two boxes represent two samples selected from that population. Notice that the sample statistics are different from one sample to another, and all of the sample statistics are different from the corresponding population parameters. The natural differences that exist by chance between a sample statistic and a population parameter are called sampling error. Even though the phrase contains the word error, this inevitable discrepancy between the parameters collected from the population and the statistics collected from the sample is not a mistake. There is no way that the smaller subset of subjects would possess the same variety of characteristics that population subjects possess. Researchers know that this is the case and account for it mathematically. As you learn the formulas you will use in practicing inferential statistics, you will learn the mathematical adjustments that are made to account for and quantify sampling error.